This is the beginning of a very epic song. See how I'm playing this. Well, a hobo life is good, of course, but look a gift mouth in the horse and listen to a tale I got here, son. It's about a yegg who was once alive back in 1895. His name was Leon Livingston. He was honest, good, clean, and brave. Showed a real kid how to behave and treat him like he was his only son. And because he never smoked or drank, his clothes were clean, shoes never stank. All around called him Flea Number One. He was the king of all hobos. He had knack, charm, and wit. He could outrun any foe with a 20-pound bindle stick. He knew all the rat lines, jumped the cannonball without a sound. Seemed like a number one would never catch the westbound. From the Klondike to the Amazon, that railroad train goes on and on. From the Klondike to the Amazon, Leon rambles on and on. Why ain't number one left his mark on fences, benches, in the park, on rail sides, railroads, and barns? Word of mouth turned him into a celebrity, an American sight to see, known in cities, towns, and farms. But in 1924, just like everyone long before, the rambler deity had finally passed. And in Cambridge, pen a tombstone sitting, and on it, it is written, a number one at rest at last. He was the king of all hobos, he had knack, charm, and wit. He could outrun any foe with a 20-pound bindle stick. He knew all the right lines, jumped a cannonball without a sound. Seemed like a number one would never catch the westbound. Seemed like a number one, never close the westbound.